Today I want to show you guys how to do double pendulum breathing in Live2D. This is actually a really simple thing that I started doing, and it just made like the breathing look so much smoother, so much more natural. So let's get into this. So what we want to do is we want to create two parameters, which is breath shoulders and breath chest. For the first one, the shoulders, I want to go into the body and I want to make another deformer for this and call this shoulders. Now, deformer hierarchy is very important, so you want to make this an outer deformer instead of an inner deformer. The two parameters, by the way, are minus 10 to 10, both of them. So what I want to do is I want to grab the shoulders deformer, and I have the divisions on 32 by 32, but you can probably do it smaller. I just like to do big divisions. So I want to grab the shoulders and pull them up. It's going to be a little bit exaggerated because it's going to be a lot less in the actual physics. Okay, and on the minus 10, I want to pull the shoulders down. So now we have a shoulders up and down on the shoulders. Then I want to create another deformer, and I call this breath chest. And then this should include everything with the head, by the way. And then I want to bind this to chest. And then we just we want this to be the chest rising and falling. Make sure that is all centered. And that looks good. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go into physics settings. And we want to create a physics group. We are just going to call this breath. Leave the input blank. Now I already have a physics preset for this, but it's two pendulums, duration 10 on both of them, shaking influence 0.5 on both of them, because we do not want any bouncing on this. Reaction time 1, overall acceleration 1. So for inputs, we are going to say breath on angle 100%, and we're going to turn this up to minus 20 to 20. Then we are going to add the breath shoulders and breath chest parameters we just made, and we want to get the maximum output that we can on this, and then increase. As you can see, we're on the exaggerated motion here. So we want to turn this down. First of all, I like to turn the scale down just because I don't want to ever go over 100%. And then we're going to turn the effectiveness down until we have something smooth. And I like that. So my effectiveness ended up being 20 for shoulders, 40 on chest. And now she breathes. So that was a very quick double pendulum breathing tutorial. I hope this helped someone, and I will see you next time. Bye guys.